Welcome to the part 2 of the Plumbob animation making movies. In the previous movie we have learned how to create a 3D Plumbob. In this tutorial we are going to animate it. I have opened a new scene in Blender. You can do that too by pressing the file and new or press Ctrl plus N to go back to a new scene. In this scene we're going to add a movie as a background instead of a photo or a picture as you have learned in the previous movie. We're now going to add a movie as a background because we can make the Plumbob move according to that movie you will import later on. You probably won't understand exactly now what we're going to do, but you will understand that later on. First thing we need to do is we're going to add the movie on the top of this cube. For some reason you cannot add it to a plane itself. You can add a plane by shift A, mesh and plane, but for some reason it won't show up in the final render. I don't know why, but it simply doesn't. So with a cube it works, so then we are going to use a cube. We're going to place that camera later on right on top of the cube, somewhere here, so we can see that also. But first we're going to change the cube to a plane, because then it will work too, by pressing the tab button to go from object mode to edit mode. We're going to Ctrl tab to the face. Now, because everything is selected, we can simply press the shift button and the right mouse button to remove the top face from the selection. Now we're pressing delete and delete the faces, so now we have a plane. And it looks like a plane, but Blender still sees it like a cube, so it will add a movie right on top if we want to, and yes we want. So we're going to tap back to the object mode. We're going to the texture panel to change the look of the object. Now the standard it's none here, so we can remove this thing. We're going to add a new texture. The standard is clouds, so if you press F12 you see pink clouds all over your cube. We don't want that of course, so we're going to change the type from the texture to image or movie, because we're going to add an image or a movie, in this case a movie of course. Type on the image that is here, click on open, and then go to your hard drive where you have saved the image, the movie. You can download the movie example from the Carl Sims 3 forum. You go to the topic of animate your 3D Plumbob, which is in the video topics, video section, and from there you can download it to somewhere on your computer. I will actually recommend it to save it to the Extraordinary Tutorial to Animate Your 3D Plumbob file, and I have done that too. The file is called EA Intro, Electronic Arts Intro, 350 frames in Pinnacle. I have recorded in Pinnacle because that will give the less conflicts with other programs such as Blender. Now we press the match movie lamp, that's over here, to change the frames. It will record the movie to 317. I don't know why it will move to 317, as the total frames, as you can see here in the title, are 315, but for some reason it does, so just don't change it. And we're going to change this one to the end of your total animation in the movie, in your file, I mean, is 250. It's too short, so we're going to click here and change it to 315. Enter. It moves around there now. So if you are zooming out with the middle mouse button, scroll wheel, you can see it will end now on the around the 315, and that's good. That's all we want. Now here in the preview window you can see the first frame of the movie. There is a little text above that is called Fraps, because I've recorded once with Fraps. The movie will be a guideline in the last in the last render screen, we won't see the move yet all, but before we are ready, we use it as a guideline. So for now, it's pretty good to have it. Let's see, we're going to change the layout and the perspective so we can see what we are doing. So first we're going to go to view, I'm going to top or press number 7 to see the plane from above. Zoom a little out to see the entire scene. Select with your right mouse button the camera. We're going to move the camera over there. Not by hand, but by following the axis to make it as accurate as possible. Because I want your camera to be placed on the exact same place as mine, and if I press the G and I just move it and I click here, and you will do the same thing, your scene probably doesn't look the same. So we're going to do it the difficult way, because we can. With the camera selected, press the G to grab it, the X to move it around the X axis, and press -7.5. Now, if you do the same, your camera will be in the exact same place as mine, and that's what we want. And of course, press Enter to confirm. With the camera still selected, press G to grab it, G to grab it, Y to move it on the Y axis, and press 6.5 to also move it 6.5 blended units to the north. Of course, enter to confirm. Go to the view and camera. Now this is the scene as it will be rendered in your render panel. Of course, you can't see a thing because there isn't something to see. Only the grid, but the grid will not be rendered in your render. It's just a guideline. Press the middle mouse button to go back out of that screen, and we are going. Press number 7 to go back to the top view. I move the camera around but with shift and little middle mouse button, zooming a little bit in and out to go back to the good view. Now, press the G button, the R to rotate the camera, the Z to rotate it around the Z axis, and press -45. Enter to confirm. Now it will look straight ahead. Press first Ctrl plus R plus Shift plus C. That's the largest shortcut there is. RNC to geometry. And now go to view top. Alright, you don't have to worry there. With the camera still selected, press GRX. G to grab it. R to rotate it. X to rotate it around the X axis. And -65. And now, if we're going to view camera, you can see the scene through the eyes of the camera. Press F12 and you can see the first frame of your movie. And here is called stand traps, because that's how the first scene will look like. Oh, wait a minute. If you see this little white thing, that's because of the lamp. Yeah, you can leave it right now, but we will delete it later on. When we have added another lamp, we're going to add a few lamps, because the plumb bulbs we are going to import will need to be lighted, of course, with a green light, but that's for later. I'm going to the top right corner of the streaming screen and drag left mouse button the screen in two. Now, that's what I can do here. Press F12 first to go to the render scene. If you click here, with your left mouse button, and you drag it, you can actually split your screen in two, and that can have a lot of different reasons to do it. In my case, I have not connected a second monitor to the first, to my computer, so we can work in this case also with split screen. Going here, in the left screen, press Escape to go here. Back from the render panel, but here it's still there, so we're going to move this thing around. Have your mouse in the middle part and left click to drag the scene. Move it a little bit there, and now we can both work and see what we are doing. Of course, we're going to have to press F12 first, but then it will be seen immediately here. So this will work a lot smoother. So for in case Blender crashes, press the file and press the save to save this thing. And now. Now we're going to add the plum bob we have made in another file. But first, scroll with the mouse on both screens until it's good visible. Yes, go to the file, left to top, and we're going to append. And append means we're going to add another object in this scene. Or you can press Shift plus F1. Now we're going to have to find that object. It's in my case in the projects file, in the sims file, in the previous 3D plan bulb. There is the where you can find it. So open it, open the file. Now you can go straight into the file, and you have to go to the object because the thing we're going to append is an object. Click plan bulb, but also shift click on the point, because the point is the lamp and we need to have both. Press enter to enter to append them to the scene, and here you can see it. If we now press F12, see, it takes a little bit longer to render it. You can see the result of an added plumb bob to your scene. Going to out of the camera view. Select this one. If you press under the numpad the dot point, the computer will calculate a new middle point here, so you can scroll around this thing. It's more convenient. It's pretty neat if you have added a, for example, add a plane, a cube, and you can make it really, 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 really small. It's hard to move around, especially if you zoom in. It's pretty hard. So now, if you press the dot window, dot button under the numpad, it's more convenient to scroll around the middle point of that cube, no matter of how far you have zoomed in or out. So you can delete this thing, going to right click the plumb bob, and then we press the dot so we can scroll around the plumb bob because we want to. Now you can see the plumb bob is pretty large compared to the plane, so we are first thing we're going to make it smaller. So right click the plumb bob, and the lamp will be changed automatically. Press the G first and the R to rotate it. Rotate it 90 degrees. Oh, why don't you do what I want? G, R, X, 90 to rotate it 90 degrees. My mistake. G, rotate, and the Y to rotate it 90 degrees, yes. Press the G, press the S to scale it, and press dot 1 to scale it 1/10 of its normal size. Now it's pretty small, as you can see. And we make it a little bit smaller, so it's not large, it's not small enough. G, S. And make it 0.6 smaller, and yes, that's enough. Go to the view, go to the front, so change the view, and select the point line. There it is, and press G, Z, minus dot 85. Minus dot 85. Enter, of course. Select the plumb bob. And press G, Z, minus dot 9 to move it more. Now go to the object panel and change the name of this plumb bob to plumb bob 0.1. This is because we're going to duplicate this plumb bob later on. So every plumb bob is called plumb bob, but now this one is the number 1. So you can separate them from the others more easily. Now we're going to the part animation in progress. Right click on the modified cube, the background, and go to the object panel and change its name to layout. Cube layout. With the layout still selected, go to the texture panel, which is over here. And if you drag the movie curve to the right, this one, you can see in the preview screen of the texture panel a preview of the movie. Now, if I move it, see, that's the movie we have added to the cube. And this is how it looks like. Every frame will make a difference in the animation. And there it stops, of course. It stopped. Going back here. This won't work because it's not rendered. This is your play button, this is your playback button to see the move in reverse. But by dragging through the frames, you can see the actually changes. And go back. Alright, you have to know that every step to the right from frame 1 to 315 is one frame. If you press F12 again, you can see on the right screen how your computer will build up that frame. F12. Now, our added cube is underneath that thing, so you can't see it in render, but here you can see this is frame 92, as you can see here, and it will look like this. In the text above, you can see the time the computer takes to build up that frame. That is over here. The time is around 90 seconds, I mean. It's not that much, but when we are adding more and more plumbobs, of course the render time will increase, and it's also the lights and the light, how it bounces to other objects, is also included in how long the render time will take. So in the final version it will take a little bit longer. If you have you know approximately the time it will need to build up one frame and you multiply it with 315, you can guess a little bit how long the total animation will be. But of course it depends on what the computer will do in one frame, so it's just an approximation. You cannot know for sure, unless you know out of your head how every frame is built up, but you probably won't. The next thing we're going to do is next to the field with N315, this one, is a field with a number. This is the number that indicates the scene where you are on now. So as I have said before, we're now on scene 92. If you change the number to any desired number between 0 and 315, you go to that desired frame. So press 50, for example, and we're going to frame 50. Press F12, you can see how frame 50 will look like. And that's it, actually. So now we're going to frame 17, because the first animation that will appear, in this case the plumbob, starts at frame 17. Press F12, and you will see this. It's the first time a plumbob appears. If you go to frame 16 and press F12, you see nothing, because there is nothing. Back to 17, F12, and here is the first appearance of an object. In the beginning, there was a plumbob. In the render field, the layout shows the place where the first plumbob first appear. Try to move the self-made plumbob 1 to the approximated place in the 3D view with G, Shift plus C to force to move the plumbob in every direction except for the Z to prevent the plumbob from moving up or down. To show what I mean, we're going to click this thing. It can be added 0.92, yes. GZ 0.9, because the lamp we need over there. And now we're going to right click the plumbob, move it approximately point GC, let's see that, somewhere around 1.9, GC2. Now press the view, we're going to change it to camera, because we're going to look to the eye of the camera. And oh, I see we have rotated the wrong way. Now we're going to fix that right away. Select the plumbob or right clicking it, select the G to grab it And we're going to rotate them on the Z axis, press the Z. And I think 90 degrees. What is happening? What is happening? G, rotate around the Z axis. G, Z, 90 degrees. Where are you now? That's strange, it disappeared. Press Ctrl plus C to go back. G, rotate around the Z axis. You have to know, sometimes Blender doesn't do the thing you want. I don't know why. But we are going to try it again. G, rotate around the Z axis. 90. Now it does what I want. View from through the camera. I press the Ctrl plus S to save this thing, just in case. And now, if you press F12, you can see in the scene here, in the render scene, this is your plumb bulb, and there is where it should be. So we're going to move this thing. You can't see it here, the preview. So therefore I have to edit the render screen here. So you can move from there, we have to move this thing. Press right click to select, press G, Shift plus C to move it only on the X and the Y axis. And we're going to move it with the mouse right there. Right click. Now if you press the F12 button, yes, you can see the change. It's now a little bit more to the place where we want it, but not exactly. So we're going to press G again, Shift C, move it a little bit further. And it's a little bit to the right. Yes, that's enough. We're going to GS to make it a little bit smaller to fit in place. Another little bit. Another little bit. GS scale. F12. And now a little bit top on the Y axis. F12 again. And yes, that's enough. That's good enough. So, now this is where the plumb bob is. Now we are going to use the timeline to indicate the plumb bob where it should be on which frame, and that indicates the move of the plumb bob. The good thing about 3D animation is we are going to define where plumb bob is on frame A and where it will should be on frame C, and then Blender will calculate where it will be in between on frame B. To see what I mean, as we're going to frame 16, remember the frame where the plumb bob isn't there. So right click the plumb bob now, press the G button to grab it, the Z to move it a little bit down underneath the frame, underneath the cube. Now because we are on frame 16, press the I button. And that will indicate where the plumb bob is on that frame. Because we only have moved it in the location, we have to click on location. If you have rotate the plumb bob, you have to click rotate to add that in the animation. We have rotated first, but this is the start position of the plumb bob, where you can see it there. You can see it here. We have to press the Y location. Now on frame 16, the plumb bob will start there, underneath the cube where you won't see it. We're going to frame 17, the frame where the plumb bob will appear, as you can see there, as you can see here. You press the Z button, the G and the Z, remove it a little bit, wrong way, yes, there it is, above. Now press the Y and location, and now you can see it. On frame 16 there is no plumb bob, on frame 17 there is a plumb bob. So it has moved. It has been moved. Go to the first frame and press Alt plus A to play back the animation. I'm going here to the first frame, Alt A, and see in the animation it moves from frame 16 to 17 to above the cube. And that is what we're going to do again with the same cube on another frame. Back to 17. You can see here the yellow lines indicate a movement to the selected cube, I mean Plumbob. So yeah, what it will do is between frame 16 and 17 the Plumbob moves to in front of the camera. Now go to frame 25 and press F12. You can see how the Plumbob has moved and has changed in size. That is what we're going to do also. While being on frame 25, press the G button to grab the Plumbob, move it with Shift plus C to the place where the in the preview Plumbob is a little bit there, I think, and press the Y location. Going to check this. Yes, it is almost good. A little bit to the right. Press the Y again and click, and then F12. Yes. The computer calculates the way the Plumbob travels from its location at frame 17 between frame 25, and at frame 25 it is at the location as you desire, which is here. And if you go back to the first frame and we are going to play this, you can see it moves exactly like we wanted. We're going to do the same thing around frame 30. So going to frame 30, press F12. And don't mind this thing, we're going to make first the way of the first Plumbob, because otherwise you will get confused pretty soon. So we have to move this thing once again. G, Shift C, and I think it will be there. Press the Y to location. Yes, a little bit in the positive Y direction. Y again. Again. A little bit back. Y location and F12. And there it is. In this way you can also work to frame 35. So 30, 35, 40 and 50. So first 35, press F12, you can see it has moved again. And now there, Y for location, press F12, a little bit back. So, for location, press F12. Yes, that's for frame 35. I think you will get a point now, but we are going to do it anyway. Frame 40, or no, yes, 40. You can also see the Plumbob has increased a little bit in size. So because of that, we are doing to G S, scale it a little bit, just a little bit. Press the Y again, and now we're going to have changed its location and its scale, because of it increased in scale. So we can click on the lock scale button. So, oh, that's enough. So Blender now is on frame 50. The Plumbob not only has moved around the axis, but it also has increased in size. We're on 40, now we're going to frame 45, press F12 again. It moves a little bit, G. The reason why I'm changing this every 5 frames, it also depends on the situation. In this case it's pretty good, because the Plumbob moves every 5 frames a little bit, and it's not going straight from there to there, but in a little bit ball move. So we are going to change where it is from here and there and there and there, because if I'm say on frame 17, for example, it will be here, and frame 25 it will be there, and I don't say Blender it will have this way, you will take the shortest way from point A to B. So therefore we're going to move this thing in little increments, in small increments, I mean. 45 has been added, I think, just to make sure. Now we're going to frame 50. Press F12 again. It has moved a little bit, but it has moved away. You can see in the background more Plumbobs are going to appear. And in the next tutorial, I will learn you how to add multiple Plumbobs and how to move them all together. But to make things easy, and you have always go to go the easy way if you can do it, we are going to move one plumb up at a time. Especially if you are not very used to Blender, you're going to do that. It's more convenient. Continue this until you arrive at frame 90. Now, to get a little bit in the future, here is frame 90. We're going to move this thing to the middle. And yes, that's pretty confusing, all those plumb ups together. That's why we're going to move this thing in small increments. So back to 50, back to 55, press F12, and that moves a little bit. Now, okay, I'm going to shut down my camera right now, because you get the point, and I will see you when we are both at frame 90. So good luck until then. Now, when you are at frame 90, you can see in the F12, in the preview panel, you can see here all the plumbles are going together. Wait a minute, so this is the wrong frame. This is 85, yes, now at 85 is here. And now you can see, there are, I have made small increments, a little bit in changes. In 85 I have made, I have moved the plumb up. And also, one frame further, in 86, because there's a small move, there's a big move, I mean, between just two frames, this will also increase the speed of the plumb up, as you can see. If it will move from frame 70 to 75, you can only see that it is moving pretty slow. But if you are going to change it from frame 70 to 71, from here to there, yes, Blender, you simply must move it fast, because otherwise it can't be at the right time over there, so it will poof, go there. And that's also what you can see here, from frame 85 to a frame 86, just a little bigger increment in one frame. And that's okay, because in the beginning of the movie it will indeed move pretty small, pretty slow, I mean. It also will increase and decrease in size, as you can see, but in the end it will move pretty fast to its final destination, which is now over here. But the last scene from all the plumb ups together is somewhere around frame 100, I think. Yes, then there's only one. It can be just one. So here, at frame 94, you can see it will melt together. And because this is simply chaos, you can't even see where all the plumb ups are. You simply have to guess where they are. So, but that's for another, for the upcoming tutorial. In this tutorial, I only will move one plumb up to make it not too difficult right away, because this thing is already difficult enough, I believe. So we will stop at frame 90, press F12, and there it is. As I said, the rest we will just guess until we are at frame 95. Yes, 95. And from there we will make in the second tutorial, make the plumb ups to one. We're not melting them together, they are simply going to appear underneath the background, so we won't see them again. And then at frame, I believe, 105, let's see what over there, the plumb up is rotating until frame 100. Rotating is another thing we're going to add later on. Still rotating, and rotating, and rotating. As you can see, the most movement is over here, so this is where we need to put the most attention in. As you can see, there is something going on over here. This is because the logo of The Sims 3 is going to rotate around the plumb up, going back after it and rotate right here pretty fast. So we're going to go a few frames into the future. You can see it here. It's blurry because of the speed. Here it is slowing down, yes, because it's going to look much better. In the next tutorial, we're going to make our own logo with your own name, if you please. In my example, I would use Lato 85 because that's obvious. And then we're going to make the animation all to the end. To make this tutorial to an end, go back to frame 1 and press this button or press Alt A to see the animation of your first plumbob. It's going bigger, smaller, and up. That last part is moving fast. Voila, you can be proud of yourself again because you have now made your plumbob to move. And oh yes, of course, don't forget to save. It's always good to save it before you quit it because that simply is a disaster. Remember, Blender won't ask you if you want to save it. It's not Windows. It will simply quit. And voila, quit. So, see you in the next tutorial.